decide to back a piece, you know, there could be several reasons to do that. I mean, if you want to hide your stitches, it's one thing. Sometimes a backing is good just because you have so much loose threads and things it's going to catch. It could have a practical aspect to it. But if you're going to back it, you might as well think about what you're backing it with. I mean, I always take into consideration stitching through the piece, so I always want to pick something that's fairly loosely woven or fine or lightweight so that it won't add too much weight and it'll be easy to stitch. And, you know, it's also an opportunity to add a design element. I mean, it's nice to, if someone's going to turn it over or you're worried about someone looking at the back, it's nice to have something contrasting or surprising on the back, as well as, you know, something that could even, you know, in this case, I've got a piece that's a little larger. I mean, one of my simplest edgings is just to fold that over and hug the edge. So you do want to think about what you're using. I mean, if it's got a back, you might as well make it nice to look at. And, you know, this is a small piece, so I don't really have to do much basting or anything to hold it together. Little safety pins work really well. It's just an easy way to work on a small piece. And the pins can stay in and you don't have to worry about sticking yourself or anything. But, you know, quilting is to attach the layers. I think of it as a functional thing. I mean, what you want to do is you want to hide the mess on the back and you want to stabilize the piece. And you want to attach the layers so they don't shift. Even though it can be decorative, it is a functional thing. So the simplest thing to do is to sew across your piece at intervals, maybe in both directions, so that everything is evenly stitched. I mean, you have to be careful not to do too much heavy quilting in one area and then leave another area unsewn, because what you get is you can even see here, you get kind of a bubbling effect. Which is okay if that's what you want, but you know, you can have shifting and strange effects. On small pieces, I a lot of times quilt with a single strand. And I'm just gonna, let's start over here. I mean, a quilting stitch is really a running stitch, a simple running stitch. And on pieces that have been embellished, it's a little different to quilt. I mean, you can take some of the open areas and just do a straight running stitch. And you can make that stitch larger if you want it to show more, or smaller if you want it to show less. I mean, that's up to you. You can use more strands if you want it to be more bold. But your basic objective, at least mine is to attach the layers. Now, the thing I wanted to show you here is when you've got a design like this, your quilting can interfere and sometimes overwhelm your design. So what I often do is I start to switch the stitch. I keep the stitch the same size on the back, but I start to transform it into of an invisible stitch when I go over an area that I don't want to be interfered with. And this will keep the tacking of your piece consistent, but it will allow your design to dominate. I kind of call this wizard stitching. I know I've mentioned it before, but your stitch can transform in size and style according to which area you're going across. And on the back, it looks fairly consistent. But on the front, it can literally disappear. You can stitch right through your embroideries, take a very tiny tack there, and you can pretty much hide it in the other stitching. But again, your attaching is consistent. Your piece will lay flat, but you haven't really destroyed your design in any way. Now, the other option you have is what I call coloring book quilting. And that would be where you choose a color of the thread that matches your design, and you can quilt and make your stitch show a little bit more, and then maybe switch into a blue over here, and then what you'll get on the back is kind of a shadowing of your design. So I'm going to continue the invisible style stitch here throughout all the face parts, and then I'll switch back into a running stitch for the ground. And how close and how much stitching you want to do, that's up to the fabrics, the piece, how you want it to look, and how much stitching it needs to hold together. And then when you're all quilted, you can either trim your piece and edge it in a normal way, or you can even leave it like this.